Yes, good morning, beta. Yesterday we had started with the chapter statistics and we had started mean. We have discussed two methods. First is your direct method. Second one is assumed mean method. And we have done the question of both the types. Now, first three questions we have done in the class. Next three I had given you for the homework. Three questions are pending from the first exercise. Let's discuss one or two of them. Then we will continue with the next topic, that is mod. Okay, so let's start with the question number 7. Question number 7 we are doing. In question number 7, you have given, let me write the details. You have given quantities, concentration of SO2 in ppm, that is a unit. Okay, that is 0.04 to 0.08, then 0.08 to 0.12, 0.12 to 0.16, then 0.16 to 0.23, then 0.24. So these details have been given to you and frequency is already given. दीक्षा रोल नंबर 11. बच्चे दीक्षा तनेजा को एक बार फिर से बता देना, अभी भी ठीक नहीं है. शी इज इन द वेटिंग रूम. आई हैव अलाउड बट काइंडली टेल हर आफ्टर द क्लास. यस लिसन, दिस थिंग इज गिवन. यस आई वांट टू टेल यू वन थिंग दैट एवरी टाइम यस लिसन every time in case of mean, median and mod, you have to take care of one thing, that data should be in continuous form. Wherever the number is finishing for the first series, it should start from the next interval, should start from that ending number of the previous one. Otherwise you have to change it to the continuous interval by subtracting 0.5 from the first, and 0.5 will be added in the upper limit. Okay, so you have to find xi, that is your class interval, class midpoint of the class interval, that is called mid value. Mid value and class mark is same, that you will get by adding lower limit plus upper limit by 2. So finally add them, that is 0.02. You will add them, that is 0.12. When you divide it by 2, it will be 0.06. Difference is, how much difference is there? 0.04. Then what you will do? You will add 0.04 to each number. 0.14, 0.18, 0.22. Is it okay? So these are your xi, that are the mid values, or you can say class mark. Now frequency is given, that is 4, 9, 2, 4, and 2. So these are your FIs. Okay, so it's up to you which method you want to apply here. You can use second method, assuming method, or you can go for the first one, direct method. So I think you should go for the direct method, that is FI, XI, kindly multiply them. That is 0.08. 0.54, 0.90, 0.28, 0.72, 0.44. Is it okay? So add them. This will give you summation. This will give you summation FI, and this will give you summation FI XI. So kindly find summation FI. Add them 9918 plus 422. 22 plus 8, that is 30. Find summation FI XI, that you will get by adding all these. 12, 22 plus 4, 26. 7, 16, 18, 18 plus 7, 25 plus 4. Is it correct? No. You are getting here 29. 9 will be written here and 2 will be written before the decimal. So it will be 2.96. Okay. Now the mean will be given by summation fi xi upon summation fi, that is 2.96 divided by 30. Okay. So please leave these three zeros, kindly divide 296 with 3, and these three zeros will be written as it is. Divided. 3 9s are 27, 2 is left, 3 8s are 24, 2 is left, 3 6 are 18, again 6 is 18, 2 is left, again 6 upon 1000. That is 0.09866, or you can write 7 also. Okay, please check the answer. Whatsoever unit is there in the question, you have to write the unit also. Now let's start with question number 9. 8th I think you all have done. So let's start with question number 9. Question number 9 is, you have given literacy rate, that is in percentage, that is 45 to 55, 55 to 65. You can check the continuity of the interval. They are already in continuous form. You please check the name of these type of intervals. What are these intervals type called? So tomorrow you will tell me whether they are called inclusive or exclusive class interval. Tomorrow you will tell me. So FIs are given, that is frequency, that is the number of cities, 3, 10, 11, 8 and 3. Now, what you have to find is, you have to find the mean literacy rate, that is in percentage. So whatsoever answer you will be getting for the mean, the unit will be percentage for that. Because we are finding literacy rate and that is in percentage. So it's compulsory to mention the unit. Find xi, that is called class mark. Class mark means mid value, that is lower limit plus upper limit by 2. Total of this is 100, that is 50. And the gap between them is 10. So add 10, 10 to each number. Okay, now you can find di here. We are going to use here assumed mean method, that is a plus summation fi di upon summation fi. Got it? A is the assumed mean that you will suppose from this xi, that is the middlemost value, that is your a. Is it okay? So this is the assumed mean. Next is your di. Di is your xi minus a. Now, x1 minus a, that is minus 20, x2 minus a, that is minus 10, x3 minus a, that is 0, 80 minus 70, that is 10, 90 minus 70, that is 20. Now, we want fi di, that is the product of these two, that is minus 60, minus 100, that is 0, 80, and this is 60. When you make total of all these, this is plus 60, this is minus 60, this will cancel out, and the answer of this is minus 20. Hope this is clear to you all. So this is your summation fi di, that is a sum of fi and di. We want summation x fi also, so find the sum of fi. This is 13 plus 11, 24. 24 plus 8 is 32. 32 plus 3 is 35. So let's put these values. X bar is assuming that is 70. This is minus 20 upon 35. Is it okay? So 70 will be written same, plus minus minus. Now cancel it out with 5. 5 fours are 5 sevens are. So this is 4 by 7. So kindly divide it. 70 minus. This is 0.5. 7 fives are 35. Again 5 is left. 7 sevens are 49. 1 is left. 1 is left. So 7 ones are 7. 3 is left. 7 fours are 28. You can divide up to 3 decimal places. It's up to you. Please subtract it and get the literacy rate in percentage. Please get the answer. So X bar, what you will be getting, you are going to tell me after subtraction. I'm waiting. Hurry up. Okay. So after subtraction, you can write three digits also. Three or two, it's up to you. ठीक है? वैसे तो आपको two, three digits, four digits लिख देनी चाहिए. कोई problem नहीं आएगी उससे. क्योंकि अगर जो board में answer की होती है, उसके साथ exact tally हो जाएगा. थोड़ा बहुत vary होगा, तो then half marks will be deducted. So better to write all the digits. Or if you want to write it in the or manner after round off, you can 4-3%. So you should, I think, according to me, you should write both the answers. Exact answer or estimated answer also. You should write both the answers. Okay. Now listen, with this, we have completed our topic of mean. So let's start with mod. Yes, in the junior classes, when we did the topic, this mod topic, what you do is the number which is having maximum frequency in the given data is called the mod of the class. The number which is occurring most frequently. So same way, but in the junior classes, always individual data is given, or the data can be in the grouped also. Frequency jiski maximum hoti thi, to aap x size mein se dekh lete the, kaun sa sabse zyada baar occur kar hai, that will be your mod. But here in class 10, you have a specific formula to get the mod of the grouped data, that is in interval form. ठीक है, जो junior classes में आप करके आए हो, मैं आपको example देती हूँ, that will clarify your these thing. जो mod हम junior classes में करके आए हैं ना, उसमें क्या होता था, या तो data individual होता था. अच्छा, मैंने आपको एक और बात बतानी है. अभी आपने देखा जो हमने calculation की थी, वो इस तरह से की थी. Don't try to take the LCM. ठीक है, वो और इंक्रीज कर देती है नंबर को. तो बेटर टू डिवाइड इट देन सबट्रैक्ट इट डायरेक्टली. डोंट गो फॉर द एलसीएम. ठीक है, दिस आई एम टेलिंग यू फ्रॉम माय एक्सपीरियंस. अगर आपने फिर भी करना है, इट्स अप टू यू, बट अकॉर्डिंग टू मी, यू शुड नॉट गो फॉर द एलसीएम मेथड. यू शुड डिवाइड इट फर्स्ट एंड एक्चुअली पहले आप क्या करोगे, पहले आप एलसीएम लोगे, एलसीएम लेके फिर माइनस करोगे, फिर डिवाइड करोगे. तो आपको ऐसे दो चीजें करनी पड़ेंगी. आपने तीन चीजें कर रहे हो, एलसीएम ले रहे हो, माइनस भी कर रहे हो, डिवाइड भी कर रहे हो. और जिस मेथड से मैं बता रही हूँ आपको, उसमें आप सिर्फ डिवाइड कर रहे हो और माइनस कर रहे हो. तो आप दो चीजें कर रहे हो, तो बेटर टू गो फॉर दैट आल्सो. नाउ इन मॉड क्या होता है, मॉड में जैसे सपोज इंडिविजुअल डाटा दे रखा है ऐसे, ठीक है. नाउ कैन यू सी दैट थ्री इज अकरिंग थ्री टाइम्स, थ्री इज हैविंग मैक्सिमम फ्रीक्वेंसी, सो थ्री इज द मॉड हियर. But if suppose group data is given like this, 20 is occurring three times, ये इसकी frequency है, ये इसका xi है, 45 is occurring four times, 60 is occurring five times, 70 is occurring two times, 57 is occurring three times. तो किसकी maximum frequency है, 60 की. So 60 is the mod. But in class 10th we are doing class interval, means grouped data जो given है, ये भी grouped है, बट यहाँ पे इस एक्स आई मेथड सिंपल गिवन है, लेकिन जो हम मेथड कर रहे हैं उसमें क्लास इंटरवल्स गिवन है. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर going to find the mod and class intervals are given, then you will apply the formula that we are just going to discuss. ठीक है, मॉड सबका आ जाता है, लेकिन जो इंटरवल्स होते हैं वी हैव सम डिफरेंट मेथड फॉर दैट. वेट, सो यू हैव फॉर्मूला फॉर मॉड एज एल प्लस एफ वन माइनस एफ जीरो अपॉन ट्वाइस ऑफ एफ वन माइनस एफ जीरो माइनस एफ टू इंटू एच. Now let's understand this formula first. Now listen. Suppose आपके पास group data given है, that is in the form of the interval, जिसकी frequency सबसे ज्यादा होगी. ठीक है, मैं example देती हूं आपको. ठीक है, ये है सपोज करो, इसकी फ्रीक्वेंसी सबसे ज्यादा है, तो ये क्लास जो होगी ये आपकी मॉडल क्लास होगी. ये आपकी मॉडल क्लास है. व्हाट सो एवर डाटा फॉर दिस फॉर्मूला यू वांट यू विल गेट फ्रॉम दिस इंटरवल. ठीक है, बाकी किसी को यूज नहीं करना, ये इंटरवल यूज होना है आपका. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द मॉडल क्लास इंटरवल. जो भी होगा ये है आपका. ये आपका क्या है, एफ वन. एफ वन इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द मॉडल क्लास. एफ वन है ना, this is the frequency of the model class. जो इसकी पहले वाली है, that is f naught or you can say f zero, that is the frequency of the preceding class. और जो आपके पास यहां पे आ रहा है, जो आपके पास next आ रहा है, that is f two, that is frequency of the succeeding class of the model class. H is the difference of this, that is class size. H is called class size. Inka difference 10. L is the lower limit of this class interval. Model in class ki model jo aapke paas interval hai, ye model class jo hai, jisme se sara data le rahe ho, L is the lower limit of this interval. Is it clear? Is it clear, beta? Okay, now let's write all these details in the notebook so that you will be able to understand the things later on when you will read it. So L is the lower limit of model class. F1 is the frequency of model class. F0 is the frequency of preceding model class. F2 is the frequency of succeeding model class. H is the class size, or you can say class width. That is upper limit minus lower limit. Is it okay? Is this clear? Okay. Chiang, is it clear? Harshdeep, Imani, Divita, Diksha. Okay. So for finding the mod, you will fill all these details in the formula and you will find the answer of your mod. So let's start with the question. You please all note it down in the free notebook that you will write in the introduction. So I'm discussing first question from the exercise, and after this, what you will do question number 2, 4, and 6 of the second exercise in your rough notebook. And after getting the correct answer, you will note that solutions in the fair notebook. So let's start with question of exercise 14.2. First question. This is age. Age is in 5 to 15. Age is in years. 15 to, please check the interval. Are they continuous? If not, you need to convert them. 35 to 45, 45 to 55, and 55 to 65. This is, you need not to find xi here because we don't need that in the formula. So you will write it as it is. And frequency is given, fi, that is number of patient, that is 6, 11, 11, 21, 23, 14, and 5. Is it clear? Now, which class interval is having maximum frequency? 23. So this is your F1, preceding class F0, succeeding class F2. Is it okay? So this is your model class. You will put them in the circle or you can put them in the square box. It's up to you. Now let's start with the formula. Mod is equal to lower limit plus F1 minus F0 twice of F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Okay, so the lower limit is 35, F1 is your 23, F0 is 21, twice of 23, minus 21, minus 14 into H. H is the class size, that is 10. Is it okay? Is it okay? Okay. 35 same, ये क्या आएगा 2, ये क्या आएगा 46, ये क्या 35, 46 minus 35, 10 यहां आ जाएगा, इसके साथ multiply होके 20, 35 plus 20 upon 11, so don't take LCM here, divide it, what you will be getting, 11 ones are 11, बच गया 9, 11 8s are 88, बच गया 2, 11 ones are 11, 9, 11, 8s are 18. So you will be getting this 36.818. It will be in continuity and we are finding mod. So yeah, aa gaya aapke paas mod. Theek hai? This we have got as mod and you in this question also you have to find the mean. Please do the mean by any of the formula, either by direct method or by assuming method. Hurry up. Kindly see whether they are same. Actually, both are the central value. So let's check, are these two values same, mean or mod? Dikha hua hai na, measure them. Measure them. Kindly compute and interpret the two measures of central tendency. Apne comparison karna hai dono mein ki kya hota hai. Get the value of mean, hurry up. So today you will do question number 2, 4 and 6 of this exercise. Okay, remaining we will discuss tomorrow in the class. Is it clear?